be a panda, hanging like a mamba. Panda, be a panda.
Flora Lesnia here. We haven't spoken in 12 years. I wonder what she looks like now. All Beth has to do is drive her son to his football match, watch him play, and then drive home. But the knowledge that her former best friend lives nearby is all-consuming. She can't resist. She parks opposite the house and is still there when Flora and her children return home. Except, something's not right. 12 years ago, Thomas and Emily were 5 and 3 years old. Today, they look exactly the same. They haven't changed at all. How is this possible? Beth knows it isn't, yet she also knows what she saw and that it was real. And, having seen it, how can she forget?
A Manchester lad from Irish traveller stock, born 3 months premature and weighing just a pound at birth, Tyson Fury grew up to become one of the most unlikely heavyweight champions in history. This dream come true soon turned to a nightmare, however, as a deep depression took hold and he was stripped of his titles. What followed was the darkest moment of Tyson's life, detailed in this book for the first time when he came within seconds of ending everything. Broccoli.
Alex Ferguson was born in 1941 in Govan, Scotland. A goal-scoring centre-forward, he was later transferred to Rangers, the club he supported from boyhood for a Scottish record fee of £65,000. Entering management in 1974, he served East Stirlingshire and St Mirren before guiding Aberdeen to victory in 1982-83, Cup Winners' Cup. Arriving at Manchester United in 1986, he brought them 38 trophies, including the Club World Cup, 2 Champions Leagues, 13 Premier Leagues and 5 FA Cups. His overall haul of 49 trophies made him the most successful British manager of all time.
When Nora Seed finds herself in the Midnight Library, she has a chance to make things right. Up until now, her life has been full of misery and regret. She feels she's let everyone down, including herself. But things are about to change.
Manamana. Manamana. Manamana.
It is a truth universally acknowledged that a single man in possession of a good fortune must be in want of a wife. What's that supposed to mean?
The snitch, his nerveless fingers fumbled for a moment with a pouch on his neck, and he pulled it out. I open at the close. Breathing fast and hard, he stared down at it. Now that he wanted time to move as slowly as possible, it seemed to have sped up. And understanding was coming so fast, it seemed to have bypassed thought. This was the close. This was the moment. He pressed the golden metal to his lips and he whispered, I am about to die.
And she said, do you come from a land down under?
Never has a man needed a friend more than when a Springer Spaniel appears in the mouth of his Afghan cave. The dog becomes a constant companion, a shadow, and that's what a man decides to call her. But life becomes more dangerous by the moment. Eventually, a man and shadow find the courage to leave. But how far can a shadow lead them? And in this terrifying new world, is anywhere really safe? Morpurgo's warmth and humanity suffuse a story of courage, love, and hope.
Papa's got a brand new bed.
Survivor by Sam Pivnick. Sam Pivnick was the ultimate survivor from a world that no longer exists. On 14 occasions, he should have been killed, but luck, his physical strength, and his determination not to die all played a part in Sam Pivnick living to tell his extraordinary life story.
Splinter from a strange silver book. That night, beneath the eerie glow of a full moon, the man transforms into the World Eater. This hideous beast prowls the streets, searching for words to eat. If the librarian doesn't stop it, every word and everything on the earth could disappear.
Rocket Man!
Chris Hadfield's An Astronaut's Guide to Life on Earth. Chris Hadfield spent decades training as an astronaut and has logged nearly 4,000 hours in space. During this time, he has broken into a space station with a Swiss Army knife, disposed of a live snake while piloting a plane, and been temporarily blinded while clinging to the exterior of an orbiting spacecraft. The secret to his success and survival is an unconventional philosophy he learned at NASA. Prepare for the worst and enjoy every moment of it. You might never get to pilot a spacecraft like Colonel Hadfield, but his refreshing, hard-won wisdom will teach you how to think like an astronaut and will change the way you view life on Earth, especially your own.
When Harold Fry leaves home one morning to post a letter, with his wife hoovering upstairs, he has no idea that he is about to walk from one end of the country to another. He has no hiking boots or map, let alone a compass, waterproof or mobile phone. All he knows is that he must keep walking to save someone else's life.
Now I'm the king of the swingers, oh, the jungle VIP.
My chosen book is a play called Blood Brothers, and the blurb says, twin brothers are separated at birth because their mother cannot afford to keep them both. She gives one of them away to wealthy Mrs. Lyons, and they grow up as friends in ignorance of their fraternity until the inevitable quarrel unleashes a bloodbath.